Hey everybody, and thanks for being here today. I hope you're having a great conference. It's a great privilege to introduce our next speaker, Lucie, a leader in the French-speaking Python community, an organizer of Python meetups in Lyon, and has been a part of the Python FR organizing committee since 2015. Today, we're excited to hear Lucie's insights on how to live from free software for real.
Hi everyone, I'm Lucie and I'm going to present how we managed to live from free software for real with real numbers at Coboyon. First, we'll talk about what is Coboyon and present what we do. I also present where do we come from so you have a bit of context and history around Coboyon and our software. After, we'll see our sources of income and after that, a feedback with what works and what don't work for us. So first, what is Coboyon and what we do? So Coboyon is two people, Guillaume Ayoub and myself, Lucie Anglade. We're both IT engineers and we're involved in the French Python community. We're also passionate about specification. You may find that weird, but why not? So the HTML, CSS and PDF specification in particular. We work on a Python library called WeasyPrint, which takes HTML and CSS files to create PDF. So it's like a browser, but instead of putting the rendering inside a window, it puts it in a PDF. So it's very useful when you have to generate a lot of invoices, reports, document with always the same visual, but with different data. And Coboyon, among other things, is just the name we use to sell services around WeasyPrint. We're both independent inside a cooperative. And if you wonder, yes, Coboyon is related to food because we also love food, not only the specification. If you're not familiar with free software is defined by four freedoms: the freedom to use, study, redistribute, and improve. So it means that our software is freely downloadable on GitHub, PyPI, on your system package manager, whatever. You can adapt it to your needs and it's also documented. And even it's something free, we manage to get money for that. So it's very cool. Now a bit of where do we come from, the date. It won't be long, don't worry. So everything started in 2011. We work in a company that do readability tests and they need to generate a lot of reports for this readability test. They try to use Word, OpenOffice, LaTeX, Firefox, but none of them is very conclusive. If you try to ask a designer to style a LaTeX document, they probably hate you after that. So in 2011, we created a WeasyPrint. Immediately it was on GitHub and a free software. In 2012, we became member of the W3C, so the people making the specification for HTML and CSS to participate in it. And among the year, WeasyPrint grew many stars on GitHub. In 2020, it was 4,000 stars. During the years, we thought, oh, maybe at the company, we can earn money from that free software, selling stuff, donation, maybe. So we started a Patreon page and at the maximum, we got around the $200 per month. So it's a start, but not really a good one. In 2020, we decided to quit this company to create Coboyon and our goal was to live from free software in maybe 3 years. We thought first that in 2020, we can start selling our services to people we know in real life. But if you remember, 2020 was also the COVID year. And so it's quite hard to sell stuff to people in real life when you're not allowed to get out your house. So instead, we started to write content to prepare the marketing part of Coboyon. At the end of September 2020, we had a line in the README of WeasyPrint saying, oh, now there is a professional support made by Coboyon. Feel free to contact us. And we launched really Coboyon on October 12. So naturally, our first customer send us an email on October 10. So do communication, it works, even when you don't really start it. So that was the context part. Now we can come to the sources of income. So it's split between how we do earn money and also other way we identify to earn money with free software but we don't necessarily use. So first, the way we use to earn money. The first one is software development. Basically, company came to us to add features and fix bugs into WeasyPrint. They pay for it. And after, all the community benefit from this new feature or this bug fix. And when another company come to pay for something else, the first one also benefit from the improvement. And so it's nice for everyone, the company, the community. It's kind of a win-win. After, we have a free way to earn money, which make us more part of the team of the company during the work with them. The first one is software integration. So we help the company to use WeasyPrint in their workflow, application, whatever, to include WeasyPrint in that. We also do a development using the software. So as I said earlier, WeasyPrint takes HTML and CSS to generate a PDF. So often people have a nice mockup of their document, but don't have the resources or the knowledge or time to actually transform them into HTML and CSS templates. So that's what we help them with. After, there is a consulting part. So it's for company who already use WeasyPrint, and we help them improve their experience with WeasyPrint. So it can be related to performance, system architecture with WeasyPrint, template simplification, whatever they need. So this free stuff is very nice because we see what people actually do with WeasyPrint, and it's always interesting. And after, there is a donation part. Now we use Open Collective for the donation. So people can become a sponsor of WeasyPrint Corbouillon, and it allows us to book time to answer people on GitHub issue, help them on pull requests, and stuff like this, so it's very important. So that's how we actually earn money with free software. There is also other sources of income we identify that could work, that can work with free software, but we don't necessarily use. The first one is selling the software. So you have the famous community edition and enterprise edition. We're not very fond of this because we think that what is open should be open for everyone. Plus, technically, with just two people, so maintaining two source code base is kind of difficult when you're just two people. Also, another way to earn money with free software is to have plugin development. So it's a bit like WordPress. WordPress is free, but you have a lot of plugins which are non-free to help you doing specific things. The same as selling the software. We think everything should be open, and maintaining different source code base is difficult when we're just two. We can also do training on the software. So for example, Real Python is selling training on Python. So more and more people become expert on Python and talk about Python to other people. And these other people came to Real Python to have their training. So it's a nice way to have new users. But we're in France, and in France, doing training is kind of difficult and implies a lot of paperwork, and we don't like paperwork, so it's not for us. Also, you can put in place a software as a service. So, for example, Sentry does that. You can install the Sentry services on your own server and manage it, see what's going wrong with your services. But if you don't have time, resources, or just don't know how to do it, you can pay Sentry and use their own service as a service. So it can be a good idea for WeasyPrint, but Still, we are just two people and not very tailored for now to do that. This surfing, we don't do it at all. And after, we have also grants and support. So it's kind of mixed. For grants, we apply sometimes to grants, but we don't have a lot of feedback for now. And we don't do it very often because it's still paperwork and we still don't like paperwork. After, we have the support part. So a lot of people said, oh yeah, you can just put one line on your website saying you do support like curl and you have easily money. So it's not exactly like this. You have to prepare a contract and stuff like this. So we did that. It was just beginning of October, so it's very recent and we don't have feedback on that for now. So that was the way we identified to earn money with free software. Now we are coming to the sales, the real numbers, the most interesting part. So Courbouillon is 4 years old and you can see our sales on Courbouillon part. We do other stuff beside Courbouillon, but it's not here. So the first year is quite small, but it's normal because it's the first year. After in 2022 until now, it's quite stable, so it's good for us for the future, we think. Each year we split our sales in 5 categories and publish an article on our blogs detailing each one and also some statistics about the software. So the first part is HTML and CSS, so it corresponds to the templating part when people come with mockup and we create HTML and CSS for them. So this part was small last year but growing again this year, so it's nice because we love to see what people do with WeasyPrint. After, we have the feature part, so when people pay to add feature in WeasyPrint or to fix bugs. So this part is becoming smaller and smaller among the year. It may be explained by the fact that the most wanted features are now in WeasyPrint and people are more interested in getting help to use WeasyPrint. So it's correlated with the consulting part here that is growing now. This year it was up to 25% of our sales. So it may be related to the feature already in WeasyPrint. After, we have the donation part, which for 3 years in a row is around 10,000 euro per year. So the donation, as I said earlier, is very important to for us to book time to answer people on GitHub issue and help them on pull requests, stuff like this, writing articles, thing. And we have another category, which contain everything that doesn't fit in the 4 precedent one. So each year it's changed depending on what we do during the year. It can be some web app development where at some point the application generate a PDF, or it can be work on other free software not related with Courbouillon. For example, in 2022, we work on the package for Windows for Mercurial. It's not related to Courbouillon, but it's free software, so it's included. So that was the numbers. So now our feedback, so what works for us, what is more complicated. So first, what works? What works is that we manage to have customers who are like us, meaning that they share value with us and it's very important. We are happy to work with them and they're happy to work with us. Everyone is happy to get on a video call on morning to speak English. So I guess it's a good thing. And also we build a long-term relationship with them, meaning they come 1 year for one stuff and they're coming back the year after and the year after. So it's very nice. And also they always have a lot of ideas to improve with WeasyPrint or some new use case. So it's very rich. Also, we have a lot of customers and users all around the world. So it's very interesting among also just for talking to people and see cultural difference around work and way of doing stuff. Very interesting. There are some big companies using our software, but don't give us necessary money. like Airbnb, Samsung, Google, Microsoft, IBM. And there is also some organization among the free software stuff like IETF and Unicode. So this year, for example, we work with Unicode to help them generate the specification, the version, the PDF version of the specification into a PDF. So with WeasyPrint, so it's cool. And with that, our software is more and more used. Now we are on the top 1% of Python packages downloads. So it's equivalent to $2 million per month. At the beginning of the year, when we did this talk, it was 1.5 million. So the community is growing really fast. And so it's very nice because we see a lot of new use case and also a lot of awful bugs, but that may be an issue. So what is more complicated for us is that we don't have a lot of long-term visibility. When we work on a feature, on adding feature or a template integration, it's always something short, so a few days to maximum 2 weeks. So we know maximum to 2 months what we're going to do, but after that, we don't know. So it leads to some up and down and uneven working hour during the year and also between Guillaume and I. On a more technical part, sometimes we have difficulty to reproduce some issues because we are Linux users, and when people report issue on Windows or macOS that we don't use, it's hard to reproduce. So if you want to give an end on that, you're welcome. And another thing that is complicated is people who think that because it's a free software, it means that we have to work freely for them. So no, if our software is very important in your company and you need a new version right now, maybe you should pay us and not ask us to work on a Sunday. Now, what set us apart? What works for us and why? And what may be interesting for you to know the context is WeasyPrint is 10 years old before being marketed. So it means during 10 years, there was already a lot of users coming. And so potential customers when we start selling services around that. Also, we're two. Often in free software, it's only one person, but we're two. So it's cool when one of us feeling down, the other one is here to cheer up. And also we're in a cooperative. So there are people dealing with the paperwork for us, and it's very nice. Also, we are on in a niche. We love specification and page layout, so it's not everyone. So it helps us to have customers, so that what set us apart, some things may work for you too, some other not, so you have to try and see what works. So in conclusion, there is a lot of people that are interesting in free software, not only to use free software, but also to improve the software and then paying people to work on it. And then have a better software and more people, etc. So you have to find these people or help them find you. It works also. So now it's your turn. Let's go and do free software. So thanks for your attention. You can find our link on the QR code or in the link below with the slide of the presentation or our social media. And feel free to get in touch. Thank you.
Thank you, Lucie, so much for that presentation. I hope everyone is having a great PyLadies conference so far.